Hello and welcome to this webinar about effective social media collection for e-discovery. My name is Daniel Schuring. I'm product manager at Xylab. And if you have any questions afterwards, you can always contact me by email to discuss any other items that are of interest. As you may have heard before, we have the Xylab community on which you can also post ideas for webinars like these so that we can address the topics of interest for you. This session is recorded and the session will be posted also in the community, including the presentation. So you have some information that you can share with colleagues afterwards. So this session is about social media collection for e-discovery. It's a very hot topic at this moment. Many companies would like to collect data from social media, such as Twitter, LinkedIn, Facebook, and all these kinds of social media channels that are present at this moment. But not only companies, law firms, but also investigators, law enforcement agencies are interested in collection of social media. There's a lot of discussion about this. It's very important that social media can be part of your e-discovery process. Not just companies are using it, lots of police agencies are using it at this moment. And we see a lot of articles in the news about the information that is available in social media, which can be very useful for the legal cases that you may have. Now, we see that social media is a communication channel. Lots of people use it to express their feelings. But for example, so websites and Twitter channels are used as official communication channels for many companies. So the information in social media can be really important. There are also lots of legal requirements for archiving social media, especially from the regulators that require organizations to capture their own social media and archive that, which also includes, for example, all the changes on their websites and all the information which is there and which is accessible for the clients. There's also important case law about social media already, where the court required the provisioning of social media content. So even by court, you can be ordered to collect certain social media channels and use that information in the legal case. Now, what we want to discuss today is how we can get that data into the Xylab system and how this will work in your e-discovery process. Now, we differentiate between different solutions for social media. We have the standard social media archiving collection, which is, let's say, the standard Twitter, LinkedIn accounts. We differentiate from website archiving because that's a little bit different than just posts on social media. And we have the enterprise social network archiving, so for example, Facebook for Workplace, Jammer, Chatter, those types of social networking solutions which are used by enterprises. And we also offer for that a solution to archive that data and use that information in your e-discovery process. Now, if we talk about the social media archiving and collection, we offer their solution to do real-time archiving. So when a message is posted, it's instantly archived to the Xylab system. We can capture all the changes and the deletions. And once all the data is captured, the data is available in the Xylab One eDiscovery Ready Archive, which I will show you later. Or it's in a separate searchable archive with the option to export the data on demand to Xylab. Now, this is a solution for Facebook, the standard Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, YouTube, Vimeo, and video networks. And for those, we can archive the data real time. If we archive the data to Xylab eDiscovery Ready Archive, we actually convert the social media posts into an email message, which is then stored in the Xylab One system. So as mentioned before, we can do this in a continuous collection. So all the data is directly converted to or collected into the Xylab One archive. It is instantly searchable and fully eDiscovery ready. The other alternative is that we first build up a social media archive and export the data from there to Xylab One. So those are the two options that are available. The other one we have is the enterprise social network archiving. So we have the workplace by Facebook, Jammer, Chatter, Google+. All posts on these social networks are also real-time archived. We capture all the changes and deletions. It's actually an automated compliance archiving. And you will have an archive of all that data with direct export to the Xylab One solution, where you can then use the information in with your case data. And then we also have the website archiving, which is also fully automated. You just add a link to a website that you would like to archive, and we create daily archives that captures the changes and the deletions. And you also have the option to compare the web pages. All the data that is captured is has a digital signature, so we can assure that the data captures is the actual data. Again, this is still stored in a searchable archive, which allows you to export the data to Xylab One. So let me show you how that looks in the Xylab system. I've got here a meter in Xylab One. And what you see here is that we have a meter called Social Media eDiscovery Ready Archive. And if you go to the start page, you have the browse option, which will show you the actual facets of the data. And in the facets, we see here the sources, for example, which is Twitter, LinkedIn, Jammer, Facebook Workplace, and websites. So this data is currently in my system. What we also have done is that we also extracted typical social media tags, like who was it sent to, with the at sign, which is being used within Twitter, or the hashtags. That type of information is extracted from all the social media outings and allows you also to organize that data. Now, for example, if you go into the Twitter documents, I go into the result list, you'll see that I've got here a list of items of posts that has been tweeted. And you'll see here on the right side, you'll see the document date of when the post was done. So if I click now on the document, you'll see that I've got now here a message that was actually posted on Twitter by Xylab. And you also see by whom it was tweeted. So if you zoom in a little bit, you see that we as Xylab are using Hootsuite, when it was actually posted, the time. And we also keep track of the retweets and the favorites. Now, if you think this document is interesting for your case, you can, of course, label it as responsive and continue to the next document and start tagging the data that you think is relevant for your case. So you can go easily through all the tweets, and I see this message is coming up more and more. It's about an event at Xylab. And you can so easily browse through all the data. Of course, you can go back to the browse section and, for example, also select a topic, a social media topic, for example, GDPR. And then you will see all the items that contain GDPR, the hashtag GDPR. And you can go through that. And if required, we can also label these as being responsive for our case. We also have the metadata from the document, so that's available as well. And of course, if you want, you can also search on the data. So, for example, if I search on relation day, that information is now also available. And viewable in the system. You see that also includes the other media that is captured, like the pictures that are included with the tweets, so that information is all accessible and available. You can also see that in the document family, where the picture is also being extracted, so we can also do all the analysis on the data if that is required. You can also go to the overview page, where you will see here the meta overview with the number of documents, the number of sources, how many documents have been reviewed. Only three now, which I just did. But you can also see here the timeline, where you can see that, for example, in June, we had a lot of new entries. That's when we started the archiving. And you see here when we had all the additions to our archive. You also see here the overview of the social media topic and who tweeted most about Xylab or retweeted and which source contains the most information. So that's all available. I can also show you here the Facebook workplace data. And what we've done there is that we have exported several data. For example, this is a case export. And what you see here is that we have the actual timestamp of the data when it was captured. And we have got all the posts and replies to the messages that are here. You also see, if I zoom in a little bit here, that the data comes with the signatures and the creation date, the modified date. So all the relevant, you know, let's say forensic data is available. And you see that this is exported as a PDF and nicely readable in our solution. We don't have just the Facebook. I can also show you here, for example, the data from Jammer that we have. Got here a document from Jammer. And that's also exported as a message. So all the posts in Jammer are actually kind of email messages. Also in here we include the additional metadata and the pictures that are included. You can see here on the left in the document family also the attachments to the post, which are both available as well in the Xylab system now and fully searchable. So that's all there, and let's go back to the website's archive that we have in place. I've got here a website that is archived. Let's go there. And this is the actual Xylab website. You will see that also this page is now being exported to PDF to the Xylab system. And you see that all the data of the web page is available now in the Xylem One eDiscovery solution and available for taking if that's needed. And here another page, I think this is the Xylem homepage. You see the links to the videos and all that information is accessible. So going back to the PowerPoint, we have a couple of subscription options for this solution. It's not an on-premise solution. It's a SaaS solution that we offer as a subscription. The subscription is can be fully managed by Xylem, which means that you will give us a link to your social media accounts. We will add the link to the system and send you a mail to authorize the application to access your posts, only read access, and then that data is being read by the collection system and sent to the Xylem One system. Basically all data, all your social media account posts are converted to an email address which is collected by the Xylem system. We also offer a subscription that you can manage everything by yourself, and then you build up your own archives, and you also have to then export the data to the Xylem system or collect the data into the Xylem system when that is needed. For website and enterprise social media archiving, capturing, we also have a subscription, and that is also managed by yourself. So you take the subscription and you can then archive the websites or the enterprise social media accounts that you have yourself. We built up an archive, and when needed, you can then export that data, or we can import the data into the Xylem One system. So this was the webinar on social media capturing. If you have more questions, you can ask them right now. If you want to know more about this, please contact your Xylem representative. They can explain you more about this, and we can perhaps do an in-depth demo or do a demo with your own social media data. That's often more interesting than the information we have. Yeah, I've got a question here. The question is, does this include the subscription, also the Xylem One system? No. The subscription for social media archiving capturing is a separate subscription than the subscription to your Xylem One. So this is an addition to the Xylem One subscription that you may already have. I don't see any other questions at this moment. Might be that there are questions that are somewhere stuck. If there are any questions that are not answered, we will answer them directly to you. And I want to thank you all for attending this webinar. And as mentioned before, the Xylem community will contain all the materials related to this presentation. So the recording will be posted there, and the presentation. And if you have any ideas or topics on which you would like to see or learn more about, let us know, and we will try to fit it into the schedule so we can have a webinar on these type of topics. So thank you very much, and have a nice day.